Hi YouTube, Cyclonius here, and first and foremost, a few days ago I made a video with regards to the situation over in Gaza and southern Israel, and I made a point to say that Hamas is to blame for the current conflict in the territory, and it suffice to say that while, yes, it is partly true that they are to blame, it's also the blame of the United States as well. Because, as always, the United States has been known and is known for instigating conflicts and giving the go-ahead to instigate a conflict. In this case, we gave the go-ahead to the Israelis to start the conflict over in Gaza. However, in lieu of that admission, it's suffice to say, at the same time, that the situation is also a tragedy. It's a tragedy because of the waste of human life. As always, my government, the United States government, is known for basically using certain situations to its advantage, and therefore human life is basically, as we would put, collateral damage. And you know, I received a comment from a user, and it was obvious that they were not thrilled at the comments that I made. And let me be first to say that I condemn any violence that involves the killing, maiming, hurting, or any form of suffering of people. With that said, however, Israel is in a peculiar position, because here we are, the United States, supporting Israel, and basically what you have in the West Bank and Gaza is practically a concentration camp, except it's not in Germany no more, rather the Middle East. And it's happening right under our noses with the support of, guess who, the United States government and the West. In that regard, the blame for the suffering of Palestinian people is rightfully so, the West and the United States. And in some aspects, I can understand why many Muslims are very biased and very angry at the way the United States does its, shall I say, politics. And let me be also the first to say that the Arab world also is to blame. Because if they were looking out for the interests of the Palestinian people, they would have been at the peace table decades ago just to resolve this conflict. But as always, both sides, both the Western and the Arab world, are to blame for the strife that's currently happening over in Gaza and the West Bank. Basically, it's the modern day version of, like I said before, Nazi Germany, except it's happening in the West Bank and Gaza. So the question in all this is, where is the solution to the problem? The solution is this, I believe. Short of nuking the place till kingdom come, I believe that the United States should force Israel to the peace table, and the Arab world should force Hamas, Hezbollah, whatever party out there that says that represents the Palestinian people, to the peace table. And they should not leave that peace table until both sides agree to stop killing each other. The main catalyst in all this is religion. Both sides say that God gave them that land, and it's their right to be there. I don't want to get into the argument of who was there first, and what belongs to who, and none of that. Because the reality is, the land, the earth, belongs to no one. We are simply its tenants. It's our duty to take care of the earth while it is in our possession, while we are living. But of course, humanity, being in its infinite wisdom, will always choose a way, somehow, to basically be in conflict with his fellow brethren. Now, I can sit here all day, all night, and post videos with regards to who's right, who's wrong, but I don't want to do that, because simply that is a waste of time. What I do want to convey is that while all this is happening, brothers, sisters, aunts, uncles, mothers, fathers are dying and suffering. And all we can do in this insane world of ours is point fingers at one another and say, you are to blame. It's easy to point fingers, and it's easy to say, it's the other guy's fault. When in reality, it's our own fault for allowing both sides to be at each other's throats this long. You know, I'm not sure what is the solution. And quite frankly, it scares me that this will go on for several more generations to come. And maybe the solution is for no one to have the land. Because no matter what peace treaty, no matter what agreement comes about, no one will be happy. It will be like a temporary peace until someone finds an excuse to start killing each other again. It's a scary thought, but it's the reality of the Middle East. And both the United States, the West, and the Arab world are to blame. Because, again, they're not looking out for the interests of the Palestinians. They're looking out for themselves. And trying to exploit the situation further, so that way they can say, You see, look at the West, or look at the Arabs, you see how they behave? So, this is what the situation is, and again, I don't see the light at the end of the tunnel. But, again, who am I to say? I'm not from the Middle East, and I'm not a Muslim, nor am I a Jew, so I'm just a person from the sidelines. Anyways, ta-da.